Hello everyone, welcome or welcome back to my channel. It's Lexi and today I am bringing you my September TBR. For September, I really want to get through 4 physical books and 1 audiobook. I really have not been reading enough audiobooks this year, and one of my goals for my 2021 reads was to get through 5 audiobooks. So I feel like to make that up for the rest of the year, I really need to be reading at least 1 every month or listening to 1 every month. And I really want to achieve that goal because I'm so close to completing everything on the list. On this page here, you can see all the 2021 reading goals. So I actually have read 40 books, so that can get ticked off. I have read a book featuring multiple generations, that can get ticked off. Last 2 points are to listen to 5 audiobooks and to read a book based somewhere where you would like to visit. I think those 2 are really, really achievable. So with that being said, the audiobook I would like to read in September is called Love Your Life by Sophie Kinsella. This just seems like a really fun and super cute romance. I'm pretty sure I've listened to one of her other books as an audiobook and I really enjoyed it. I do find that thrillers and romance are the best audiobooks to listen to for myself. If it's just like a contemporary, I'll sort of get a little bit bored, but I find the romance ones and the thrillers pretty good. The book basically follows our 2 main characters, so the 2 love interests, and they both have really opposite, quirks. And she is someone who's sick of online dating and she has this sort of meet cute moment with this guy. So despite all of the opposites, she does really want to make it work. And I guess we just follow them along on that sort of crazy journey. And it's actually been a little while since I read a romance. Probably the last ones were in the plus size readathon. So it'll definitely be good to jump back into that genre as well. The second book that I want to read in the month of September is Girls with Rebel Souls. So I believe this is the final book in the Girls with Sharp Sticks series. The second book is Girls with Razor Hearts, and I absolutely loved the first 2. I think I even loved the second one more than the first book. Without spoiling the series, I'll give you the gist of the first book. First book follows these girls who go to Innovations Academy. It's basically a boarding school. As they're just sort of progressing through their lives at the school, they start to pick up that things are really not what they seem. And we follow them through this journey of sort of awakening to what's around them and learning how to deal with that. It was a really great story of friendship and sisterhood. There is a romance, but the thing that I loved about these books was that it didn't bring it to the forefront. It was just sort of there and it existed. It was great, but the whole plotline of the story was very female driven. So I'm definitely looking forward to how the conclusion goes for this. The third book that I'd like to get to in September is The 7 Husbands of Evelyn Hugo by Taylor Jenkins Reid. So this one is pretty popular here on BookTube. Most people have already read it. I am currently reading Daisy Jones and the 6th. I am not very far into it, but I'm definitely liking what I've read so far. And I really want to get to these 2 books because of Malibu Rising coming out. I did watch one of Emma Books's vlogs and she did note that the 3 books are all set in the same universe. So I really want to read these 2 so that I can appreciate all the Easter eggs in Malibu Rising. So The 7 Husbands of Evelyn Hugo follows our main character, Evelyn Hugo. Who is a famous 1950s movie star. I believe she is now like older and she sits down with a journalist and sort of tells her life story. And it seems to be that there is many bumps along the way and everybody says that it's a book that you really fall in love with. So I'm definitely excited to read this one and see if I agree with all the hype. I have recently been reading a lot of books that are really hyped up on BookTube or Bookstagram and not really identifying with it. But I'm hoping that for both of these Taylor Jenkins read books that I do really love them. And if I do, I'll definitely be following up with Malibu Rising. The next book that I would like to read is Fable by Adrienne Young. So this one is actually the Fairy Loot edition. It's got the sparkly edges and this exclusive cover. Fable basically follows a 17-year-old girl who is born into, I guess, the pirate life. Her father abandons her on an island and then she sort of just has to adapt and survive. And then she meets a boy and I guess they go on this journey to find find her father or take over from her father maybe. And I love like anything to do with the sea, like mermaid stories or pirate stories. Like I'm always down to read those.
Ever seen anything so wonderful in your entire life?
So that's why I knew I was gonna love this book and I was really excited to purchase the Fairy Loot box. I do have a video of opening that Fairy Loot box. I will leave it linked up here. And yeah, so it's definitely time to venture out into the pirate world and read Fable. And this one may be a little ambitious, but if I do get time during the month, I would love to read A Court of Frost and Starlight. So this is the next one that I'm up to in the Akatar series. I have sort of been putting it off because I know that the book after this is just so huge. It's a massive chunker.
That's what she said.
And really big books just intimidate me. I don't know why, but they do. So if I make my way through the rest of the books on my TBR, I will be grabbing this one. I feel like it doesn't need any explanation. Everybody on here knows the Akatar series, and I definitely have mixed opinions. It's good, I enjoy reading it, but it's definitely not up there as a favorite. And I know that's kind of a controversial opinion, but I just feel like there are so many better series out there. But nevertheless, I would like to finish the series. So I think I'm going to leave my TBR list there. So I've got 4 physical books to read and 1 audiobook. I'm really looking forward to all of these books. I think they're going to be amazing. Make sure to let me know down in the comments which books you will be reading in September. I'd love to know what you're reading and if we have any of the same books on our TBR. Thank you guys so, so much for watching. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And I will see you guys in the next video. Bye!